So now it's ready for shading. Here's the kicker with this. I've uploaded a cleaner, kind of more, a little slightly crisper version of the still life, because when I have these packets printed off, they printed really, really poorly. I don't know if I didn't hold it down quite well enough or whatever it is, but I was able to scan this copy of it, and this is the copy that I want you to shade from. So instead of looking at this while you shade this one, what I would recommend doing is, if this is going to be in your way visually, I would take and fold this so you're not able to see the version up top. And then while you shade, be sure that you're shading from the one that's on the Google Classroom. So this new updated image will be on the same slide as this shading video. Just be sure that when you shade, don't look at this copy, because you can see the overall difference. I mean, especially in this cube, the brights are much brighter, the darks are a little more deep and a little more artistically visible, instead of kind of spotty and really kind of hazy. So once you are ready to begin shading, go ahead, fold this in half. Be sure that you look at the copy that's on the Google Classroom. And when you shade, you want to shade in the same order that you illustrated these. So we started by sketching out the circle first, then the cube, then the cylinder, then the cone. When you shade them, you want to shade in that same exact order. Remember, for the deepest darks, layer. Don't just scribble really, really, really hard. And don't worry about the cast shadows or the background shading until all four of these objects are completed. Take your time on this. This should take an entire block to shade. If you get it finished, don't move on. Just go back, retake a look, compare the values that you've got to the values that are visible in the original. But like I said, take your time. Start with the object that we illustrated first, and then you're ready to go.